बस ठीक। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेक मेटल्स। सी एंटर दिस बोर्ड मेटल्स। इन तमिल फॉर मेटल्स वी कॉल इट उलोगम। वी कॉल इट एस उलोगम। उ लो क इम। अट इन इंग्लिश यू एल ओ जी ए एम। सी एम राइटिंग वंस अगेन। इस उ This is low, and then this is ka, this is im. So we call it as pronounced as logam. So let us go one by one. First is a gold. For gold in Tamil we call it as tangam. Thangam I written in English. In Tamil it is written like this. Ta, ing. क इम तंगम। फॉर गोल्ड वी कॉल्ड इट तंगम। वन सेकंड राइटिंग दिस क दिस इंग दिस इज क एंड दिस इम। सो इट इज कॉल्ड तंगम। नाउ सेकंड वन वी कम फॉर सिल्वर। फॉर सिल्वर इट इज कॉल्ड वेल्डी। वी ई एल एल आई आई रूट इन इंग्लिश। इन तमिल इट इज लाइक दिस वे वेल्ली। नॉर्मली एनी ऑर्नमेंट्स इफ दे वॉन्ट टू मेक इट दे चूज फ्राइडे। सो सिल्वर इज मेंट फॉर फ्राइडे वीनस। बिकॉज यू नो वेन दैट वी सी दिस प्लैनेट थ्रू द टेलीस्कोप देयर इज अ सिल्वर लाइन पासिंग थ्रू दिस। So even for silver, not only silver, even for Friday we call this Vendi. I already taught you. So the same now once again writing this Vendi. Vendi means silver. Now third one is iron. Iron in Tamil it's called Irumbu. Irumbu are written in English as the pronunciation. In Tamil it is E. रू इम बू इरुम्बु। I'm writing once again ई रू इम बू इरुम्बु। Now the fourth one is zinc. What you call zinc in English? This is called tuthanadam. In Tamil, it's called tuthanadam. I written in English thuthanadam. See how it is written in Tamil. It is tu. It. The. This is na. The. Im. Tuthanadam. See, for sing in Tamil it is called Tuttanadam. I am repeating once again. Tu, it, ta, na, ta, im, Tuttanadam. Then fifth one is lead. Lead is called EM in Tamil. In English I have written EYAM. In Tamil it is called this E. This is called E. Bigger E. E, you know we call it. E. This Ya, Yamaka Ya. And this Im. Yam. You know most of the vessels, you know, for polish, they use Yam. Then sixth one is copper. Copper is a good conductor of electricity. So for copper we call it as Tamiram. Thamiram written in English. This is Tamil. Ta mi ra im. Tamiram. Ta mi ra im. Called Tamiram. Then the seventh one is tin. For tin, we call it as in Tamil as tagaram. I written in English THAGARAM. See how it is written in Tamil. This is ta, this is gha, and this is ra, and this is im. So it's called tagaram. And once again, repeat. This is ta, gha, ra, im. Tagaram means tin. Now comes eighth one is steel. We call it egg. E-G-G-U written in English. This special word, I told you this special word is called Aayurvedic in Tamil. It is found very rarely. It is in literature you find this letter very rarely. So this egg, for steel we say egg. A-ig, this is called egg and scoop. So once again writing this. This you have to just like a three in a triangle, three circle you write is egg and this is go. Egg. The ninth one is a brass. For brass, it's called pithalai. In Hindi they call pithal. P-I-T-H-A-L-A-I written in English. Now let us how we are writing Tamil. P it the lie. Amri. See, this is P, this is it. Whenever there is a dot, I told you, it's consonant. It, you will say. If it is, this is the, and if the dot is there, it's called it. So P, it, the lie. Pithalai. Okay. Now, 10th metal is a bronze. It's a very heaviest metal. They say German metal. It's a very heaviest. Nowadays, nobody is using this bronze. But it's a very good for cooking. So, in the native place still, you find that it's in the villages and all, they use a bronze. It's a very heavy metal. B-R-O-N-Z-E-R-T-A-N. It's called Venkalam. In Tamil, it's called Ven. I written V-E-N-K-A-L-A-M. This Ven Kalam. Ve, this in three circle. Three circle means it's called in. If it is two circle, it's called in. So see how we are writing. Ve in ka la im. I'm repeating once again. This is ve one letter. In and ka la im. It's called Venkalam. Now 11th one is a magnet. Everybody knows that magnet. It always shows north-south directions. It's called Kandam. When there is, it has got an attractive power. It's called Kanda Shakti, we say. That Shakti is called Kanda Shakti. So, you know, magnet, we call it as Kandam. K-A-A-N-T-H-A-M. How it is in Tamil? Ka, this ka. This ind, this is the and this im, kandam, it's called ka, in, the, im, dot is required. See, for magnet it's called kandam. Ka, in, the, im, kantam. Now, 12th one is called Mercury. The Mercury belongs to the Wednesday planet. It's Mercury. It represents the Wednesday. So, this is called Padarasam. In Tamil, it's called Padarasam. Pa, the, ra, sa, इम पादरसम. दिस नॉर्मली इन ए थर्मामीटर दे यूज मेरकुरी बिकॉज इट कैन रिमेन सॉलिड स्टेट एज वेल एज लिक्विड स्टेट. इट स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ मेटल. So it is used in a thermometer to show the temperature. So it's called Padarasam. Pa-da-ra-sa-im. Padarasam. And the last one is called Platinum. It's a very heaviest metal. People used to wear, but it's a very costly metal. Road we cannot purchase. It's not in the budget. But it is called Banpun. It's called Banpon, V-A-N-P-O-N-N. It's called Banpon. There's a dot here. One, this is Va, this is In, this is Va, and this is In, this is Po, this is In. So it's called Banpon. It is the heaviest metal, I told you. So we have taken all the metals today. Today I am taking the other lesson called Neram. Neram means in a day is split up into 7 parts. Early morning from the sun rises, before that, early morning before sunrise and after sunset, and the afternoon and evening and night, like that. These are the different parts of a day. So Neram means the time, you know, the particular time it should be split up. So let us see how we are calling this. See, always Adi means it represents sun, sun god. Adi means before, no, the previous one. So here, early morning before sunrise, see actually the time is called Brahma Muhurtam. Between 4 to 6 is called Brahma Muhurtam. It's a very good time for doing yoga and it is a time of tranquility. Even in the temples and all, we can see in southern temples, all the temples, the puja, first Nirmale Darshan, what they call. So they do it at a time of 4 o'clock. It's a very auspicious time. So this 4 to 6 is called Brahma Muhurtam, which we call Adhikale, before sun rises. So Adhikale. A-ti-ka-lai. If we get up early in the morning before sun and do anything, see, even the yogis, they do the yoga and all at this Brahma Muhurtam. When we study, we can pick up the matter fast. It's a time, very good time for Brahma Muhurtam. Then comes second is Kale. Just like this Adi Kale. Kale means after sun rises, after 6 o'clock. K-A-W-A-L-A-A, written in English. In Tamil it is written Kalai. Don't say Kalai. If Kalai means, it becomes bold in Tamil. Lai, this is Lai. So it's called Kalai. Kalai. Then third one is Pagal. Pagal means day. So day is called Pagal. 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 Once again, this is Pa, this is Ka, this is Il Pagal. Then Pang, the midday. Midday means exactly the sun comes above our head, scorching sun, except afternoon. So it has got two names. Nadupagal. Nadupagal. Nadu means center. Since the afternoon comes, exactly the sun comes in the center. It is Nadupagal. 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 There is other name for this afternoon. इट्स कॉल्ड नन पगल, न इन प ग इल, नन पगल, इट्स आल्सो कॉल्ड नन पगल, बोथ आर राइट, यू कैन राइट एनीथिंग, नडुपगल और नन पगल, ये सर्कल. Then fifth one is Malai. Malai means, see, Malai means evening. But there are other meaning also for Malai. Certain words have got two meaning. For Malai is also for garland, we say Malai. But normally here it is evening, Malai. Malai Velai we say, time. Now, the sixth one is night, what you call Iravu, I-R-A-V-U, and it's got other name called Ratri. So this in Tamil Iravu is written E-R-A-V-U, that time in English this one, it's called Iravu, Iravu. Then again other name is called Ratri, Ra. It, T, Ri. So this Iravu, Iravu. Then this Ratri, Ra, It, Ti, Ri. So Ratri. So I've given you the Neram, totally in a day, how it is split up to different parts. Now other one, the seventh one, is midnight, what you call in English. We say Nadu Iravu. Nadu means mid. Na Du I Ra Bu. Iravu means night. So Nadu Iravu means midnight. Na Du I Ra Bu. It has got another name called Nalli Ravu. Na Il Li Ra Wu. Na il ri ra wu. So this is called Nalli Ravu.